problem is to write a Python program to display powers of 2 using anonymous function. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Chen. In this video, we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to check the power of 2 using anonymous function. First of all, talking about the anonymous function over here, anonymous function is the lambda function that is used in our Python. The lambda function is called as the anonymous function. What does this lambda function do? It is a temporary function. That means we do not have to give it any name. As soon as we use the term lambda and whatever task we need to do, we need to put it inside the colon and we can write only one expression inside it and it will be executed. So lambda is a temporary function over here when we don't want to create a whole function and so that it stores a memory, or let's say it makes a code lengthy and we want to use only one single line statement function, that in that case we use a lambda function over here. Now what do we need to do? Using this lambda function, we need to create a power of 2. We need to write a program that will allow us to show the power of 2. Now what is the power of 2 over here? Let's understand that. So suppose from the user, what we will do, we will take a user input, that number, or we can take n terms as well. So n terms is equal to, let's say I have taken 5. So how this will work? 2 raised to the power 1, 2 raised to the power 2, 2 raised to the power 3, 2 raised to the power 4, and 2 raised to the power 5. This should be our output, like whatever the result is, that should be our output in case of n terms. This is what our program basically wants, that 2 raised to the power 1, whatever it is, the value should come over here. Okay, 2 raised to the power 2, that means 4 itself, 2 raised to the power 3. So whatever the value should be, that should come in our output screen. That is what our program is asking us for. Now how to write this program? Let's have a look on that. First of all, as I said, we will be needing the n terms over here. So n terms is equals to int input. Enter a number here. Okay. So user will enter a number here. After this, now what do we need to do is we need to use our lambda function and all the values will be stored inside the list. So let's create a list over here. So I'll be writing a variable called as power. Power is equals to, inside this, first of all, let's use the lambda function. So lambda, and I'm giving it a name as lambda x is equals to, or we can put a colon, 2 raised to the power the x. Now what will be this x? 2 raised to the power x we have given, but what is this x? For the x, we will be giving a range. That range will be from 0 to the number of terms we have. So we can start it from the 0, or we can directly write n terms plus 1. Now this lambda function needs to be applied on this whole range. For that, we will be using our map function in our Python. That map allows us to put this whole function inside a range. That means it will iterate and put it inside the each number of each range. This, it will apply this lambda method on each number over here. And we need to create a list over here. That's why what I will be doing, I'll be writing list in front of it. And as soon as I print power over here and run it, so let's see what output we get. So if I write 5, it gives me 2 raised to the power 1 is 1. It gives me 2 raised to the power 0 is 1, 2 raised to the power 1 is 2, 2 raised to the power 2 is 4, 2 raised to the power 3 is 8, raised to the power 4 is 16, raised to the power 5 is 32 over here. That means we are getting the output. Now how do I need to arrange it? That I need to arrange it in this way, that we should know that 2 raised to the power 5 is, let's say, 32, or 2 raised to the power 8 is, let's say, whatever the number is, right? So for that, I'll be using a for loop over here. So as of now, I'll just put it inside the comment. And we can write for I in range. Now the range would be the items that are there inside this list. Now the range would be again the n terms plus 1 over here. So n terms plus 1 colon. What do we need to print is that the value of 2 raised to the power. Power is I. So I is storing all our numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we'll be writing is. Now how to get the elements? To get the list elements, we write the indexes over here, because we have a list over here. So to get this element, we know that whatever our list name is, we write the list name plus the index number over there. So index number is getting stored inside our I. So what we can do, we can write the name of the list, that is power, and inside the square bracket we can pass I. Now as soon as I run it, let's see what output we get. So if I write 5 over here, it's giving me the value of 2 raised to the power 0 is 1. To the value of 2 raised to the power 1 is 2. The value of 2 raised to the power 2 is 4. And similarly for 3, we have 8, 4, we have 16, and 5, we have 32. So we can write any value over here. So if I run it all over again and put any other number, let's say if I put even 20, so we'll get the output up to 20 as well. That 2 raised to the power 20 is 10,48,576. So I hope, guys, that the method is clear to you. All we need to do is use an anonymous function inside a range of n terms, that whatever terms we have asked from the user. After that, we need to use the map function over here. The map function will allow us to iterate over this range and put this lambda function inside the whole range. After that, we have to create a list of all the numbers that we obtain through this function. And then we have to iterate and write the values of all the elements inside the list in a perfect manner. So I hope that you guys have no doubts and no questions. And for more such interesting programs, stay connected, guys. Thank you.